Now then, how do, and welcome to A Bit More Yorkshire Brass once again. David Hoyle with you with another couple of hours of your brass band favourites and a bit of banter. Show number 207 this week in our online YouTube series. We began with an absolute cracker of an arrangement by Howard Snell of the music of Dmitri Shostakovich, the Brick House and Rastrick Band playing Folk Festival. Lots to come in the next couple of hours. Thanks for your dedications, requests and your emails. Just general banter, some lovely stuff. And we'll be continuing the strange laws in America that we looked at last week. We'll have another set of those coming up very soon. Let's have the first march of the week. Ted and John. Ted lives in Derby, John in Glasgow, and they have an annual meetup. They were together in the forces and they have an annual meeting with their wives Sheila and Annie. This year they're going to York for a weekend break. Very much looking forward to it, and we'd lovely to play a really appropriately named march if at all possible, say Ted and John. We certainly can do that for you boys. Carl Tyker, the composer, the Wingates Band playing here. The march you've chosen, quite rightly, is called Old Comrades. We'll be right back. The match that almost wasn't published. Carl Tyker's Old Comrades, played there by the Wingates Band. Look the story up and you'll find that when Carl Tyker took that match to his superior said, "We've got too many of these, throw it in the oven and burn it." So glad he didn't. Ted and John and your lovely wife Sheila and Annie have a wonderful weekend in York. Always great to meet up with old comrades and friends, isn't it? Now then, the overture this week has been chosen by Bridget. She lives in Ayr in Scotland. I wonder if you could play me the Academic Festival Overture by Brahms, says Bridget. I'm sure you've got a good recording. I've got a few actually, and I've chosen this one by the Black Dyke Band on this week's programme for you, Bridget. Thanks for your lovely words on your email. Thanks for listening to the show. Here we go with the Academic Festival Overture. excellent to listen to, lovely to play. The Academic Festival Overture by Brahms, played there by the Black Dyke Band for Bridget in Ayr in Scotland. Bridget emailed the show, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com, with that particular request, as did Dave in Tamworth. Now, this is a lovely recording from the 1970s that Dave wants to share with us all, and it features Philip McCann, a young Philip McCann, with the Fairy Band. Dave says, please could you play Henry Purcell's Trumpet Tune and Air? We certainly can. Here we go, Dave. A young Philip McCann with the Fairy Band there, playing Henry Purcell's Trumpet Tune and Air. Thanks to Dave in Tamworth for that request. I remember playing the trumpet tune part of that as a very young player in one of the music festivals where you played on your own and everybody had to play the same tune. I never won any of them, but I didn't do bad. I got some nice feedback. Probably only about 8 or 9 years old, to be fair, when I played that tune. Many, many years ago, of course. How dare it be so many years ago? Jenny, talking about many years. How dare I be 75 this week, says Jenny. My neighbours have asked me to send a request in for me because they don't have email, but they like listening to your show. They're called Stella and Mike, and we all live in a lovely part of Swansea. We love the programme and wondered if you could pick something from one of the stage musicals, which we're all big fans of. Certainly can. This is a Welsh band, the Cory Band, playing here, and the music of Frederick Lerver. This is a selection from My Fair Lady. Happy birthday, Jenny in Swansea.
Thank you.
grand selection from My Fair Lady, the music of Frederick Lerva, played there by the Corey Band. For Jenny in Swansea, who is 75 this coming week, sent in from neighbours Stella and Mike, but it's sent from Jenny's email, because Stella and Mike don't do emails and they don't want to. Well, good on you. If you don't want to do it, don't do it. Leeds is our next stop. Hello to Kevin. Thank you very much for this one. This is a lovely recording by the Philip Jones Brass Ensemble and a very old piece of music by Tilman Cesato. In fact, it dates back to the mid-1500s. Cesato was born in 1510, passed away in 1570. And he wrote this lovely piece of music, which Kevin wants to share with us all. Thanks, Kevin. It is indeed lovely. It's another one of those pieces which I'm not sure how the title is pronounced. It could be Ronde, it could be Ronda, or it could just be Ronde. Whichever's correct. Let's have a listen. Lovely piece of music played by the Philip Jones Brass Ensemble. The music of Tilman Cesato, written in the 1500s. That could be called Ronde, it could be Ronda, it could be Ronde. Whatever, Kevin in Leeds. Thank you very, very much for choosing that on A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. Now, back to this list. We started it last week of some of the very strange laws which have existed in America at one time or another. We're not saying that they exist now, but certainly in the past. All of these have some of them will still be present. This time we're starting with Florida. In Sarasota, it's illegal to sing in a public place while attired in a swimsuit. Well, I should think so. Absolutely. A special law prohibits unmarried women from parachuting on a Sunday, or she shall risk arrest, fine, or jail. What a strange law. If an elephant is left tied to a parking meter, then you must pay the parking fee, just as you would for a vehicle. Fancy, well, the parking meter surely would get dragged away by the elephant. What a strange law that is. In Florida, it's also illegal to tell your neighbour his house is on fire. Really? So your neighbour's house is on fire. He can't see it, but you can't tell him. I find that very strange. It's also illegal to skateboard without a licence. I agree with that. Anybody should have, a license for a skate. I think they're dangerous if they're ridden incorrectly. They're not great, and I'm not a fan. Women may be fined for falling asleep under a hairdryer, as can the salon owner. Oh dear, how strange that one. And you are not allowed to break more than 3 dishes per day or chip the edges of more than 4 cups and saucers? Do they have a patrol? Does someone come knocking on everybody's door every day? Let's have a look at your plates. Let's have a look at your cups. I don't think they do. I think that's a very silly rule indeed. So in Murfield, you're up next, Flower, and a lovely TV theme tune by Henry Mancini, the great Henry Mancini, and arranged for brass band by another great, the late great Gough Richards. The CWS Glasgow Band are playing your choice here. This is one of the most nice and lovely TV theme tunes for a long number of years. The Thornbirds. The CWS Glasgow Band playing Gough Richards' arrangement of the music of Henry Mancini. That was the theme from the TV series The Thornbirds for Sue in Murfield. 1983, Sue, when that one first hit our TV screens. Jason in Halifax is up next. We've got two test pieces this week. This one's in the first half. And it's quite often used, is this one, in little bits. So a band might just play one movement of this whole thing as part of its concert repertoire. Jason says, I remember playing the whole lot pre-COVID in a contest and thoroughly enjoyed it. The audiences do like listening to it. It's a very listenable piece of music. Absolutely, Jason. The Virtuosi Brass Band of Great Britain are playing here. Gustav Holst, the composer, and Jason in Halifax has chosen the second suite in F major. Thank you. The second suite in F major, the whole lot of it, by Gustav Holst, the virtuosi brass band of Great Britain, playing there for Jason in Halifax. Thanks, Jason, for your request on the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. Once again, if you want to join the group, find the group in Facebook, send a request to join. I will add you into the group with pleasure. Next up, we're in the part of the programme where we've got something that's really lovely and listenable and slow in the main. Stephen Morpeth in the northeast has been in touch to say, could you please wish happy birthday to my wife? Your wife's name on the email is Windy Wendy. Steve, I think you might be in a little bit of trouble. Oh dear. Windy Wendy. And you've sent a few requests in with the same name. I'm going to do what you've asked me to do. Read it out as Windy Wendy. Happy birthday, Windy Wendy. Here's the Rainford Band and another arrangement by Gough Richards. Light as air. That's lovely, isn't it? Light as Air, arranged by Gough Richards for brass band and played by the Rainford Band. That was requested by Steve in Morpeth to wish his wife, Windy Wendy, a very happy birthday. Young man, I think you might be in trouble. But we're going to be reading Windy Wendy's name out again in the not-too-distant future with some more requests. Johnny Mexborough brings the first part of this week's A Bit More Yorkshire Brass to a close with a fairly short piece of music, but John says, I love to hear this, particularly in something like a town hall which has such resonance. If it's played properly, it's brilliant. Well, it's played properly on this recording by the Black Dyke Band. This music by Elgar Howarth is scintillating. Let's have a listen to the King's Hunting Jig. Music of Elgar Howarth, the Black Dyke Band, played the King's Hunting Jig for John in Mexborough. Great way to end the first part of this week's A Bit More Yorkshire Brass with me, David Hoyle. You listen to show number 207 this week in our YouTube online series. We begin the second part of the programme with a Cornick trio. Diane in Huddersfield has been in touch to request this. This has been used as a couple of theme tunes on radio programmes. I think one may well have been a brass band programme in days gone by as well. The Brickhouse and Rastrick Band are featured here. As I say, it's a Cornick trio. The music of Leroy Anderson, Bugler's Holiday. Thank you. Douglas Holiday by Leroy Anderson, the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band. Well done to the Cornet Trio playing there. Diane in Huddersfield, that was for you. Thank you very much indeed for the request. Back to this list now of very strange laws in America. This time we're in Georgia, and in Acworth in Georgia, all citizens must own a rake. I wonder how many people tread on the rake and then smack themselves in the face with the handle. More common than you think, you know. I've done it once and it hurts, let me tell you. It's against the law to tie a giraffe to a telephone pole or a street lamp. I should think so. It's cruel. Donkeys may not be kept in a bathtub. Well, that's cruel as well. If anyone's daft enough to do it, well, how dare you? And in Gainesville, Georgia, chicken must be eaten with the hands. You cannot eat chicken with a knife and a fork. It's also illegal in Georgia to use profanity in the presence of a corpse. Oh dear. We'll move on from that one. It's illegal for a chicken to cross the road in Kitman in Georgia. Well, try telling the chicken. Good luck on that one. And in Jonesboro, it's illegal to say, oh boy. I wonder why that is. Now in Marietta, this is awful anyway. It's illegal to spit from a car or a bus. I should think it is. But you can spit from a truck. How disgusting. How dare you. Second march of the week, Tim in Selby. This has been chosen for you. A lesser played march system, but we do hear it on Whit Friday. Yeah, I've heard this played a couple of times on Whit Friday. Written by Aud Hume, the Pemberton Old Wigan Band are playing here. The Elephant. Thank you. Lord Hume's March, The Elephant, was played there by the Pemberton Old Wigan Band. That was for Tim in Selby. Jeff in Droylsden's been in touch on the email, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. Could I please hear this wonderful record by James Shepherd on your programme? It's written by Arben and it's called Tyrolean Variations. Jeff in Droylsden says this is Jim at his very best and he's playing here with James Shepherd Versatile Brass. Ha 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 ha! Late great James Shepherd, Jim Shepherd, with James Shepherd Versatile Brass, playing the music of Mr. Arben, Tyrolean Variations. Jeff in Droylsden quite rightly describes that as the great man at his very best. It's so listenable and the sound is wonderful. Manchester is our next stop, Stuart and Ellie with this one, and music from the 1970s from the pop chart. Stuart says, I've played this a couple of times with our band and we all seem to like it. We keep getting it out, so we must do. Would you share it with the listeners? Certainly. This is the music of Van McCoy, and the Williams Fairy Band are playing here, The Hustle.
Thank you.
Music which charted for Van McCoy and the Soul City Symphony in 1975. The Hustle, the Williams Ferry Band playing there for Stuart and Ellie in Manchester. Thank you both for that one. Phil in York is up next. Now, this is a piece which, if you've played it, you'll know that it brings challenges. And it's a bit Marmite, some people say. You either love it or you really don't. I'm not sure. I sit on the line with it because I've played a couple of different parts in this piece, and one of them I really enjoyed and the other one I found a bit difficult, if I'm honest. There's one bit in this piece which doesn't always work for me. Sorry, Peter Graham. But most of your other stuff does, absolutely. Phil says, could we please see a Shine as the Light? Yeah, absolutely not a problem at all. The Grimthorpe Colliery Band playing here for you. Thank you. Shine as the Light by Peter Graham, the Grimethorpe Colliery Band playing there for Phil. Phil is in York, thank you very much indeed. York to Sheffield now, our Nige, how do, says Nige, how do young man. Could I please hear Scarborough Fair, Ray Woodfield's arrangement. I've just booked to go and see the cricket at Scarborough in the summer. I'm making three visits and I'm staying in three different hotels because I like a bit of variety. Once in the north, once in the south and once in the middle. Well, that's a good do. I used to go to Scarborough regularly as a child myself, Nige, and watch the cricket. Here we go, the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band with Ray Woodfield's Scarborough Fair. Lovely arrangement by Ray Woodfield of Scarborough Fair, played there for Nigel in Sheffield by the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band. Thanks, Nigel, for your request on the email, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com, the same address that Liz in Baildon has used for this one. This is a great piece of music and arranged for brass band by Bill Geldard. Pennine Brass are playing here, and I know when you've... I will get emails about this one saying, what is that music? It's called Just a Closer Walk with Thee.
Thank you.
Pennine Brass playing Bill Geldard's arrangement of the music of Kenneth Morris. Just a Closer Walk with Thee, the title of that piece of music. And Patsy Cline. You listen for the Patsy Cline version. I think it's absolutely brilliant. Liz in Bailden, thank you very much indeed for that one. Our second test piece of the week is coming up now. Danny in Church Fenton has requested this one. Danny says, I'm a big fan of the music of Kenneth Downey. It's always well thought out and very listenable. Could I hear, please, music from Kantara? You certainly can. The Milner Band here to play it. Thank you. The second test piece of this week's programme, music from Cantara by Kenneth Downey. That was played by the Milnrow Band, and Danny in Church Fenton made that particular request. Let's just take a few more of these strange laws in America. We're going to Hawaii for the final ones this week. We'll continue them next week with some more states. But in Hawaii, all residents may be fined as a result of not owning a boat. Now, this is a really interesting one because there is a way around this one. And what some people do is they go to a toy shop and buy, like, a matchbox, you know. Certainly in my age, a matchbox was a car or whatever, a matchbox model. And that's how people get around it. It's supposed to be a large boat, but they turn a blind eye to it. Coins are not allowed to be placed in one's ears. Oh, dear. Anyone who has got big enough ears to put coins in, unless, of course, they're just putting them in the bit where you would put your earplugs, as I call them. But it's not a good idea anyway, so don't do it. In Honolulu, in Hawaii, within the limits of any public park, it is unlawful to annoy any bird. Well, it should be unlawful anyway. Let them get on with their lives, that's what I say. And also, in Hawaii in general, it is illegal to get a tattoo behind your ear or on your eyelid unless you are in the presence of a registered doctor. How strange. How strange is that? More of these next week. Now, Imtune time, lovely one this week. Very patriotic indeed. Eve is in Chesterfield. I'd love you to play the hymn tune Jerusalem, please, if you can, Oily, on any show at the beginning to the middle of April. Well, this is the show that we're going to play it for you. The music of Hubert Parry is played here by the Dinnington Colliery Band. Lovely hymn tune by Hubert Parry, Jerusalem, played by the Dinnington Colliery Band. Thanks to Eve in Chesterfield. As always, the hymn tune, the penultimate piece of music in A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. And we're finishing off today with an absolute cracker of a piece of music to celebrate an 86th birthday. That is for Ron in Thurlston in South Yorkshire. Happy birthday to you, my friend. And we're going to listen to some music from a 1955 World War II British film. It chronicles the preparation for the execution of Operation Chastise on May the 16th, 17th, 1943, in which a British air squadron used bouncing bombs to destroy dams that were vital to Germany's production of war material. You know what's coming, don't you? The Brickhouse and Rastrick Band are going to play us out this week. Thanks for listening. David Hoyle presented show 207 this week in the YouTube series A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. I'll be back next week with programme number 208. Here we go with the finale for this week by Eric Coates, the Dambusters March. Thanks again. See you next week. Ta-ra!